Hello my dear friends, let us continue the topic impulse response and its properties. Okay, in my last video class, what I have covered, how to represent an impulse signal, what is the meaning of unit impulse signal, okay, what is the meaning of any impulse, that means impulse having area A. A is suppose area of the impulse, then how to denote, that also I have told. And how to write the definition of impulse mathematically, that idea also I have provided. And you know, impulse signal is basically obtained from a rectangular pulse. So that is why the impulse is nothing but an even signal, you can say, because rectangular pulse is even signal, and maintaining the height remains, maintaining the area remains constant, you are reducing the width equally from both sides, so that we are getting the impulse signal. That idea I have provided in my last class. Okay, anyway, now let me discuss. So what I have covered in my last class, del t, suppose del t, you are saying this is unit impulse, this is equal to infinite at t is not equal to 0, this is equal to 0, t is equal to 0, and is very important in the definition, this last line is very important. So integration minus infinity to infinity del t dt is equal to 1. What does it mean? It means the area under impulse is equal to 1. So that is why this impulse is known as unit impulse. Why unit impulse? Because the area 1. Remember, unit word is for area. Unit impulse, area unity, area 1. So now, suppose you are having a del t. How to define it? A del t is equal to infinite. T is not equal to 0. It is equal to 0 for t is equal to 0. And is very important, integration minus infinity to infinity, a del t is the total signal, a del t dt, that means area under the total signal with respect to time axis, that is very important, under time axis, with respect to time axis, that is equal to a. It is not actually 1, it is a. So that is why this impulse is not known as unit impulse. How to read it? It is known as impulse having area a, or impulse having strength a. In this way you can read this impulse signal. But this impulse, you can say, this is a unit impulse signal. Understood? So this is the mathematical definition of unit impulse. This is the mathematical definition of any impulse having area A, any impulse having strength A. Okay? So now let us discuss the properties. Also, I have told how you have got this impulse. I have told, suppose you are having a signal in my last class, you just see. Last discussion, I have covered detailed idea of this impulse, how you are getting impulse, how to represent the impulse, etc. So now, suppose this is actually minus t to t. Now, this suppose having 1 by 2t, try to understand. So now, what is the area? Area is height into width, or width into height, 1 by 2t into 2t, that is 1. This impulse having area 1, this pulse having area 1, and if you reduce the width of the pulse, maintaining the area 1 constant, or preserving the area is 1, then height automatically increases. Now, if you reduce this to 0, then automatically you will find a signal which you are saying that impulse signal. Since it is even function, so therefore that impulse, whatever the impulse you are getting from this pulse, that is also even. Okay? So that is why impulse is an even signal. Okay? So anyway, so now how to represent graphically this impulse signal? So this impulse signal, suppose this is unit impulse. Unit impulse why? Area 1. Remember, area 1, that's why unit impulse. So you can represent in this manner, an arrow going towards infinite at t is equal to 0. This is, you can say, del t. Before this, 1 is there. That means area 1. Area 1. Understood? So this is the graphical representation of impulse signal, unit impulse signal. Suppose here you are saying this is t axis. Now see, this is not actually del t, this is a del t. Then same representation you can use. So this is an arrow which is going towards infinite at t is equal to 0. So whose area is A? Here the area is 1. Area 1, area A. So these are the graphical notation, graphical representation which are used for impulse signals. Okay? Understood? This is unit impulse. This is impulse having strength A. Impulse having area A. Understood? Okay. Now see. Now let us discuss the properties one by one. Very, very important properties you have to mark, how you are discussing, how you are giving the knowledge of the properties of impulse, and finally you have to remember these properties because these properties having application in future study of signals and systems. Okay, so many questions you may get from these properties of impulse. Okay, so now see, suppose you are having first property, let me cover. Suppose, so first property is what? Impulse is an even signal. Impulse is an even signal. Again, I'm repeating, impulse is an even signal. That means del of minus t is equal to del of t. A function is said to be even if x of minus t is equal to x of t. Even our concept also I will discuss later. For the timing, just remember, any function is said to be even or any signal is said to be even if this condition is satisfied. What is the condition? X of minus t is equal to x of t. Understood? Del of minus t is equal to del of t. So this must be satisfied in case of your impulse. Definitely. Okay, इसका प्रूफ भी कर सकते हो. अगर मैथमेटिकल डेफिनेशन, अगर डेफिनेशन कोई भी सिग्नल का मालूम है तो आराम से सब कुछ मिल सकता है. अगर तुम्हारा कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर है तो आराम से सब कुछ मिल सकता है. अभी देख लेते हैं इसका डेफिनेशन. इसका डेफिनेशन क्या है? यू नो डेल्टी. व्हाट इज डेल्टी? डेल्टी इज इक्वल टू इनफाइनाइट, टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो. इट इज कॉन्टिन्यूस टाइम इम्पल्स. रिमेंबर इट. इफ इट डिस्क्रीट टाइम इम्पल्स देन दिस डेफिनेशन विल नॉट वैलिड. अनदर डेफिनेशन यू हैव टू यूज, आई विल डिस्कस लेटर. Okay, so del t is equal to infinite, t is equal to 0. It is equal to 0, t is not equal to 0. Dhyan se dekho. And is important, integration minus infinity to infinity, that means area. Area under del t. Area under del t. So this del t dt. Which area? Time area with respect to time. Here horizontal axis you want to consider time axis is equal to 1. This is the definition of impulse. See, unit impulse. Okay, now, so this you must remember, and how this is the definition. Actually, this definition I have discussed in my last video class, detailed discussion. Okay, anyway, so del t is equal to infinite, t is equal to 0. Del t is equal to 0, t is not equal to 0. And minus infinity to infinity integration del t dt is equal to 1. Understood? Now, see, in place of t, you can use, actually, what we are doing? Here, time axis is there. Now, this is your del t, 0. With respect to time axis, so this is the definition. That means here you are drawing the signal in this way, whose area is 1. With respect to time axis, this is the definition. Try to understand. This axis is time axis. Now suppose in place of t, I am using minus t. So what you will find? Del of minus t, dhyan se dekho, del of minus t is equal to infinite. Here minus t is equal to 0. Dhyan se dekhna. Minus t is equal to 0. Is equal to 0. When a minus t is not equal to 0. And integration minus infinity to infinity del of minus t, dhyan se dekho, actually in the definition, try to understand the meaning of this integration properly. Here minus infinity to infinity, that means which is the variable quantity? T. That means here t is from minus infinity to t is infinite. T is minus infinity to t is equal to infinite. Here t from minus infinity to infinity. Now, if you use minus t in place of t, ध्यान से देखना, तो here t is from minus infinity to t is from infinity नहीं है, minus t is from minus infinity to minus t is equal to infinite. ध्यान से देखो, minus t is equal to minus infinity to minus t is equal to infinite. Here remember, when you are putting the integration limit in place of t, what variable is minus t? That means you have to consider minus t from minus infinity to minus t is equal to infinite. Understood? Now del of minus t, now d of minus t. In place of t, everywhere you are using minus t is equal to 1. Dekho dhyan se. Dhyan se dekhna. Tumko kya prove karna hai? Del of minus t is equal to del t. Ye tumko show karna hai. Dekho, ye mil gaya. In place of t, you have used minus t. Dekho dhyan se. Main kya kar raha hun yahan pe? Pehle dekho, isko dekh lete hain. So del of minus t is equal to infinite, minus t is equal to 0. What does it mean? It means t is equal to 0. Dhyan se dekho. Here, is equal to 0 when minus t is not equal to 0. What does it mean? T is not equal to 0. Are minus sign you can multiply? Both sides. Good. Now here, t is equal to minus t is equal to minus infinite. Dekho, minus t is equal to minus infinite. When? Now what is t? T is equal to infinite. Because you have to change it. With respect to t, everything you are changing to t axis. Here t axis, here t axis. Okay, minus t axis you are not considering. T axis, because your plot must be on t axis. Everywhere you are considering t axis. Understood? देखो, minus t is equal to minus infinite. T is equal to कितना? Infinite. Minus t is equal to here infinite. T is equal to कितना? Minus infinite. That means when you change to t domain, then these two limits will change. Minus infinity becomes plus infinite becomes minus infinite. Understood? Good. Now see. So here what you have to do? Del of minus t, b of minus t. Actually, which is variable? Variable is minus t here. But you have to take the variable as t. So therefore, you can represent here, which is equal to. Dhyan se dekho. Minus infinity to infinity becomes infinity to minus infinite. Because t, what is the limiting value of t you have to put here? Now, del of minus t is there. Dhyan se dekha. Del of minus t is there. Now, why del of minus t is there? Because you are changing this t axis, not the function. Function is del of minus t. You are going to find out for del of minus t value. Okay? Now, this is a minus of d of t. Minus sign you can take out. Dhyan se dekho. Is equal to 1. Clear or not? Now, if you take this minus sign to this side, dhyan se dekho. If you take this minus sign to this side, clear? Dekho dhyan se. To kya ho jayega? Minus sign bahar a gaya. That is equal to minus sign bahar a gaya. Integration. My infinity to minus infinity. Dhyan se dekho. So, this is your del of minus t. No problem. Now, this is your dt. Because minus sign I am taking outside. Is equal to 1. Which implies? देखो, इंटीग्रेशन के बाहर अगर माइनस साइन है तो लिमिट चेंज हो जाएगा. माइनस साइन है ना, लिमिट चेंज हो जाएगा. देखो, इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस इंटीग्रेशन बी टू ए. अगर माइनस इंटीग्रेशन बी टू ए, दैट इज इक्वल इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी. दैट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल. ओके, सो नाउ दिस यू कैन चेंज. इंटीग्रेशन इन्फिनिटी टू माइनस इन्फिनिटी बिकम्स माइनस इन्फिनिटी इन्फिनिटी. नाउ दिस माइनस साइन यू हैव एंटर्ड इन द लिमिट ऑफ द इंटीग्रेशन. अंडरस्टूड? ओके. Now this is del of minus t dt is equal to 1. देखो ध्यान से. तो अगर ये तीनों को लोगे, del of minus t infinity t is equal to 0, del of minus t 0 t is not equal to 0, integration minus infinity infinity del of minus t dt is equal to 1. देखो यहां पे t का जिन जिन वैल्यू के लिए, देखो ध्यान से, t का जिन जिन वैल्यू के लिए जो जो था फंक्शन का वैल्यू, यहीं पे वही मिल रहा है. देखो ध्यान से, t इज इक्वल जीरो वैल्यू इनफाइनाइट, t इज नॉट इक्वल जीरो वैल्यू जीरो, एंड इंटीग्रेशन वैल्यू वन. सिमिलरली हियर जस्ट मार्क, t इज इक्वल टू जीरो, t इज इक्वल टू जीरो वैल्यू इनफाइनाइट, t इज नॉट इक्वल जीरो वैल्यू जीरो, एंड इंटीग्रेशन का वैल्यू कितना होगा? वन. दैट मीन्स इट इज फॉलोइंग द सेम डेफिनेशन. सो व्हाट डज इट मीन? डेल ऑफ माइनस t इज इक्वल टू डेल t. अंडरस्टूड और नॉट? फ्रॉम डेफिनेशन डेल ऑफ माइनस t इज इक्वल टू डेल्ट. देखो ध्यान से, डेल ऑफ माइनस टी इज इक्वल टू डेल्ट. इस तरह देखो, मैथमेटिकली मैं शो कर दिया ना, डेल ऑफ माइनस टी इज इक्वल टू डेल्ट. समझ में आ गया कि नहीं आया? ठीक है. स्टूडेंट लोगों को यहां पे कंफ्यूजन थोड़ा होता है. स्टूडेंट लोगों को यहां पे थोड़ा कंफ्यूजन होता है. क्यों? क्योंकि यहां पे जो वेरिएबल पुट करना थोड़ा सा मुश्किल लगता है. सर, यहां पे टी माइनस इन्फिनिटी से माइनस टी क्यों लिया? माइनस टी माइनस इन्फिनिटी से माइनस टी प्लस इन्फिनिटी क्यों लिया? अरे क्यों? क्योंकि मैं पूरा डोमेन चेंज किया ना. यहाँ पे टी एक्सिस नहीं लेके मैं पहले माइनस टी एक्सिस ले लिया ना, उसके बाद टी में कन्वर्ट कर रहा हूँ. इसलिए ऐसा हुआ, डेफिनेशन में पुट किया. अदरवाइज यू कैन फॉलो अनदर प्रोसीजर. कैसे? देखो ध्यान से देखना इसको. ये समझ में आ गया? गुड. और एक प्रोसेस देखो, और एक प्रोसेस. कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. सो यू कैन पुट एक्चुअली टी के प्लेस पे माइनस टी. डेल ऑफ माइनस टी इज इक्वल टू इनफाइनाइट. सो माइनस टी इक्वल टू जीरो, यहां से टी तुमको मिल जाएगा जीरो. इज इक्वल टू जीरो, माइनस टी इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, यहां पे टी इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो मिल गया. कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. नाउ डेल ऑफ माइनस टी का इंटीग्रेशन वैल्यू निकालो. डेल ऑफ माइनस टी का इंटीग्रेशन वैल्यू निकालो. समझ में आ रहा है कि नहीं? इंटीग्रेशन वैल्यू निकालो. ठीक है, तो क्या मिलता है उसको देखो. डेल ऑफ माइनस टी का इंटीग्रेशन वैल्यू निकालो. अगर इंटीग्रेशन वैल्यू वन मिल गया तो प्रीवियस डेफिनेशन को फॉलो किया. समझो, ये जो डेल टी का डेफिनेशन को फॉलो किया. देखो अब इंटीग्रेशन मैं डायरेक्टली इस तरह करता हूं, वहां पे डेफिनेशन में पुट किया इन प्लेस ऑफ टी माइनस टी, बट यहां पे एरिया अंडर द कर्व फाइंड आउट कर रहा हूं. एरिया अंडर द कर्व फाइंड आउट कर रहा हूं. समझ में आ रहा है कि नहीं? तो एरिया अंडर द कर्व किसका? कौन सा कर्व? डेल ऑफ माइनस टी का. देखो, इंटीग्रेशन माइनस इनफिनिटी इनफिनिटी डेल ऑफ माइनस टी डी टी, इसका वैल्यू अब निकालूंगा.
अगर इसका वैल्यू 1 मिल गया तो ये दोनों तो फॉलो कर रहे हैं, t इक्वल 0 में इनफिनिटी, t इक्वल टू t नॉट इक्वल 0 में 0, फॉलो कर रहे हैं। अगर एरिया भी 1 हो गया तो मतलब प्रीवियस फंक्शन के साथ ये फंक्शन सेम होगा। समझ में आ रहा है कि नहीं? ये ब्यूटीफुल कांसेप्ट है। देखो तो मैं क्या कर रहा हूं, पुट एक्चुअली ये वेरिएबल किसके लिए, dt मतलब किसके लिए, t के लिए वेरिएबल, d किसके साथ अटैच है, t के साथ। दैट मींस यहां पे लिमिटिंग वेरिएबल किसके लिए, लिमिट का वैल्यू किसके लिए, t के लिए, ये याद रखना। ओके, पुट माइनस टी इज इक्वल टू पी सपोज, एनी अदर वेरिएबल मैं यूजिंग, व्हिच इंप्लाइज टी इज इक्वल टू माइनस पी, ये मैं पुट किया, व्हिच इंप्लाइज डी टी इज इक्वल टू माइनस डी पी। ध्यान से देखो इसको, नाउ व्हेन टी इज इक्वल टू माइनस इन्फिनिटी, एक्चुअली हियर किसके लिए वेरिएबल, टी के लिए। नाउ टी जब माइनस इन्फिनिट, पी क्या हो जाएगा, इन्फिनिट, अरे यहाँ पे माइनस इन्फिनिट पुट करना। ओके, व्हेन टी इज इक्वल टू इन्फिनिट, ये व्हेन है, व्हेन, ये व्हेन, व्हेन टी इज इक्वल टू इन्फिनिट, पी इज इक्वल टू कितना होगा, माइनस इन्फिनिट। ध्यान से देखो ना, t is equal to infinite, p is equal to minus infinite. That means this integration you have to change to p domain. If you change to p domain, देखो क्या हो जाएगा इसका वैल्यू, इंटीग्रेशन का वैल्यू, ध्यान से देखो, ये इंटीग्रेशन t from minus infinity to infinity, now p from infinity to minus infinity. अरे when t is equal to minus infinite, p is equal to infinite. When t is equal to infinite, p is equal to minus infinite. यहाँ पे infinite था minus infinite होगा, यहाँ पे minus infinity था infinity हो जाएगा. Good. Now डेल ऑफ माइनस टी की जगह पे पी, नाउ डी टी इज इक्वल टू माइनस डी पी, यू कैन यूज माइनस डी पी। ध्यान से देखो ना, माइनस एन यू कैन टेक आउटसाइड, दिस इज माइनस इंटीग्रेशन इन्फिनिट टू माइनस इन्फिनिटी डेल पी डी पी। ओके, नाउ इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस माइनस साइन इन द इंटीग्रेशन लिमिट, जनरली इट विल चेंज, आई हैव टोल्ड ना, हियर दिस कॉन्सेप्ट आई हैव यूज्ड। सो नाउ दिस इज माइनस इन्फिनिटी इन्फिनिटी डेल पी डी पी। Now in case of definite integral, you can use dummy variable. Or in place of p, again if you use directly t, then there is no problem. Or integration 1 to 2, x dx is same as integration 1 to 2. Agar limit same hai, this is actually t dt. 1 to 2, this is same as p dp. In place of x, you can use any variable. So here definite integral, del p dp, that is same as integration minus infinity infinity, del t dt. Or in case of p, you can use actually t. Now its value is 1 in both. Understood? That means this value you have got finally what? 1. Finally 1. That means it is following the definition. See, del of minus t is equal to infinite, t is equal to 0. Del of minus t is equal to 0, t is not equal to 0. And area under del of minus t is equal to 1. That means it is following this definition. So that is why you can say del of minus t is equal to del t. So what you can say? Del of minus t is equal to del t. Any problem? So that means you can say impulse is an even signal. There is no problem. Okay. And also you can see graphically, again I am repeating, graphically you can see also this impulse is an even signal. Okay. How? So I have told impulse is nothing but a pulse. Pulse, which pulse? Rectangular pulse. And you know rectangular pulse is an even signal. So this is actually the impulse. It is going towards infinite in this manner, infinite in this manner. It is going towards infinite. Actually, it is not this height. It is going towards infinite. Very long, narrow rectangular pulse. Okay. So this is an even signal. So therefore, its notation is graphically. इतना बड़ा को तो show नहीं कर सकते ना, इसलिए इस तरह दिखाया जाता है. Whose area is 1. इसका area क्या होगा? 1. समझ में आ रहा है? So this is an even signal. That's why this is an even signal. So impulse is an even signal. Understood? So first property clear. Impulse is an even signal. Okay? In my next lecture, I will discuss other properties of impulse. Okay? Thank you.